Let me today tell you some of the anecdotes about the seventh Maharaja of Patiala, Sir Bhupender Singh. He was a tall, handsome man, 6 feet 4 inches tall, with nice blue piercing eyes, sensuous lips. He was fond of three things: hunting, polo, and sex. As far as hunting is concerned, he was ruthless, along with other rulers of Nabha and Sangrur, Faridkot. He had choicest 300 polo horses in his stable. Regarding the sex, he was most interested in. He would get the girls in a very young age, and when they would attain puberty, he would write to the British government to recognize a particular girl who has now grown up to be a woman, to be as Maharani, so that any son through her would be a legitimate claimant to the throne. He was like a connoisseur while choosing his women. He would choose from different nationalities all over the world, Spanish, Italian, and he would choose, of course, the Indian women also. But he had such a perverted understanding of sex that he had his walls of his palaces and the ceiling of his palace with the exotic, erotic paintings at Khajuraho or in Kama Sutra, and he would like to practice those positions with these young girls in a silk hammock and all that. The interesting part was he would, according to his own taste, change their physical anatomies. Like if he liked a fruit like mango, he would ask his plastic surgeons, they were brought from Europe and from India, who would change the shape of their breasts to look like mangoes, and similarly other perversities he had. He had accumulated about 350 choicest women in his harem. And it would be like during the summers, his harem would move out to the swimming pool. Huge chunks of ice would be floating in the pool, giving a very nice aroma in the surroundings. He would keep about a score of girls on the rim of the swimming pool, bare-breasted girls, so that he would go occasionally swimming to them, have a sip of whiskey or caress their breast, and then come back. He had perverted orgies in his palace. The tantritism really fascinated him. And if you read the details given by Diwan, Jarmanidas are so weird. You could throw up. Maharaja and his officials had no time for administration. So the British resident decided that a British minister should be employed to look into the affairs of the Maharaja. His name was Frederick. Frederick was very frustrated because the Maharaja won't see him for months. And he was about to complain to the British resident, and the Maharaja came to know about it. He didn't want to do that because it would mean something very serious. So what he did, he at the last time when he knew that now he was getting too frustrated, Frederick, he engaged a few of his officials, told them to study the files, and then discussed with them about his decisions, and gave the decisions offhand, without putting much mind to it. So that in his meeting with Frederick, he said, okay, I've been working. In fact, I've not been able to meet you because I was busy in the administration of my state. And these are the files I got. So I was going through all of these, and you can have a look at these. Frederick was very impressed, and so he reported to the Viceroy that the Maharaja was busy administering the state, and he was a very efficient administrator. A saint from Banaras came and made a fool of Maharaja Bhupender Singh in the guise of a saint that could fly. But it was a trick played on Maharaja, and he extracted a lot of money from Sir Bhupender Singh. His palace, called Leela Mahal, is still in Patiala. It was very intricately built. I mean, there was zigzag entrance so that nobody could see across it, 30 feet high walls with eucalyptus trees, so that nobody could assess what's going on inside those walls, which was the usual way of doing. You feel so small standing out of these palaces. Once I was in Agra, trying to take photographs of the Taj and the fort from the riverside. And the riverside is a big bushy lot. When I looked at those huge fort sturdy walls, I felt very small, and I could imagine the plight of those people whose daughters, wives, or any other women folk have been abducted by the soldiers or by the prince themselves. And it is, you can see the enormity of the whole palace, and you feel so small and feel so helpless against that mighty palace. Even as big a man, as healthy a man as Sir Bhupender Singh could not do probably justice to these 350 women. Soon he needed aphrodisiacs, so the French doctors, the Indian herbs, pearls, iron, gold, silver, everything was tried on him for a long time. It was like a crushed head of a sparrow. But soon these aphrodisiacs started to lose their effects, and the Maharaja started feeling weak and started losing his health. So more and more aphrodisiacs were brought in. But you see, this was his only pastime, sex. In his last moments, when Sir Bhupender Singh was dying, of course, all his Maharanis and Ranis, etc., were around his bed and wailing. I don't think so that anybody could really love a person like him. It was only for the love of the gifts that they would receive from the Maharaja that these women would be clamoring for. Eventually, for a long, long time till he died, during his last few years, he could not indulge in his pastime as much as he would. And nobody could understand that the malady that he was suffering was, it affected many of his fellow rulers. It was boredom. He died of boredom.